So you've obviously been photographing for a long time. Was there a particular moment that you knew you wanted to be a photographer?
Well, it's interesting, Annie. You know, I started out, both my parents were artists themselves, so I always knew from an early age that that's something that I would like to pursue. And I thought that I would be a graphic designer like my father. And then I went to art school. I went to about three different art schools and finally graduated at St. Mary's College, and was very disappointed after I got out of college that all the jobs that were available to me at that time were actually paced up and technical jobs. They weren't really creative. So I was really getting quite disappointed. I had never taken photography in school, and it was right around that time that I had seen an exhibit of Ansel Adams' work, the great environmental portrait photographer who made Yosemite famous and so many national parks with his beautiful pictures. In any case, I was so taken, Annie, by his photographs. They were all in black and white, but they had incredible detail and wonderful kind of delineation between gray and white and black and all the middle tones, and it was quite stunning to see. And I was so taken back by that that I asked about Ansel to the exhibit staff, and they said, oh, he happens to live in California. So that very next Monday, I picked up the phone and called information for a listing on Ansel Adams because I heard that he was living in Carmel Valley, which was about an hour and a half from me. And sure enough, he was listed and he picked up the phone, and that's how I got started in photography. He invited me to come down and I learned a little bit from him. There are certain things to this day that I think about, like pre-visualization, visualizing the final picture before you even meet the person or before you even take that photograph. So those kind of things really ingrained themselves on me. And also, I think just the aesthetics of taking a picture, the technical background, what it takes to make a fine negative, and in these days, you know, a well-exposed digital frame. So that's pretty much how I started out. I had a couple of lucky breaks very early on, and I never thought of myself going into documenting well-known people, but after meeting with Ansel Adams and working with him for several months, I realized there's no way I could ever measure up to his type of photography. So I ended up pursuing meeting Richard Avedon, who was this photographer, worked out of New York, one of the great fashion photographers in the world. And I was always very impressed with his work. And it wasn't quite as easy as it was with Ansel. It took me a couple of weeks of coming back every day to his studio before he gave me time, or his studio manager gave me time to actually meet with Richard personally. And it was that moment that was really the epiphany for me. I came back to San Francisco and started building a portfolio of well-known people just to get recognized. And that landed me a job at a small theater, entertainment theater, and it was there that I met individuals such as Frank Sinatra. And once I got some work with Frank Sinatra, he was sort of my big first client, and then he introduced me to other people, and that's how my work kind of spun out of that particular experience. But I guess working in entertainment, I always had this deep interest to pursue photographing people who were making a difference. And I think for me, that really came back to a time when I was about 10 years old, and my parents were big Robert F. Kennedy supporters. They had supported John F. Kennedy's campaign, and when Bobby had announced that he wanted to run for president, they of course were very much behind that campaign and brought us as a family out to hear him speak and to meet him. And as a 10-year-old, that really made a big impression on me. I think it was the first time I had ever met and seen somebody in person that was in public service and was dedicating his life in service to others. And 2 months later, he was assassinated. So that made a big impression on me as a young boy that, you know, maybe whatever I ended up doing in my life as an artist, perhaps I could focus on something that would give back to the community. And shortly thereafter, when I was in high school, I saw a movie on Mother Teresa's life called Something Beautiful for God. And in retrospect, looking back on my life, I often think that that's how God works with each one of us. You know, he kind of peppers us with different things providentially that will get interested in particular subjects, or, you know, the loves that we have in our life, the vocational discernment that we end up going with, and that direction, that trajectory in life that we end up following as a path. certainly was laid out for me even as early as high school years when I saw the movie on Mother, and that got me very interested to think that perhaps there's a living saint living among us. And even at that time when I was reading magazines and books about her, after seeing this film in high school, she wasn't on the world stage necessarily, but there was a lot written about her at the time. And it wasn't until years later that I had the opportunity to meet her face to face when she was coming out to San Francisco to give a talk. And then it was through there that she had invited me to come back to her home to see how she had set up that home and to see the work that she was doing. And as soon as I arrived at the door, she asked me to drive her to some of her appointments that day. So that's how we got to know each other. Wasn't easy with Mother because she had this deal with God that she told me that I always wanted to photograph her, of course, and I always wanted to take a portrait of her. But early she said that she had this deal with God that for every photograph taken of her, a soul was released from purgatory. So you can imagine the pressure I was under taking her photograph. In fact, years later, when I was photographing her with a sea of other photographers in Washington, D.C., she recognized me in the crowd, probably with my bald head, and came over shaking her finger with a smile saying, "Today the place was cleaned out." So we had cleaned out purgatory with all the photos we had taken that day.
Wow.
But so it's been an amazing journey, Annie, and I think it really started with my folks nurturing that artistic talent and bringing us to exhibits and galleries and museums on the weekend. And then years later, following that vocational path into the arts and then, you know, coming into photography really on a whim after I got out of school and basically was self-taught. Made a lot of mistakes and I continue to make a lot of mistakes.